Dear students, today we do a problem of Stokes' theorem. In the previous video, we already discussed what is Stokes' theorem and how do we apply Stokes' theorem for certain problems. Now, see the question. Use Stokes' theorem to evaluate integral over C f dot dr where f is equal to 2zi plus 3xj plus 5yk and c is the boundary of the paraboloid x square plus y square plus z is equal to 4 for which c is positively oriented. And by Stokes' theorem we know that integral over c f dot dr, that is the line integral or it is work done, same as the work done, is equal to double integral over the surface curl f dot n ds, where we have been given another formula which has been reduced from this as double integral over s curl f dot del g da, double integral over a curl f dot del g da, that is the surface integral has been changed into the area over the region, curl f dot del g da, and what is g is the given surface. Actually the line integral over c, in Green's theorem we know that line integral over c f dx plus g dy, that is integral f dot dr is equal to double integral over sigma, which is given by double integral over sigma dou f dou g by dou x minus dou f by dou y dE. But in this case line integral f dot dr is given by double integral is the surface integral curl f dot n ds. And what is the difference of this from the Green's theorem is that here the function f is a three variable function, or we are considering this vector valued function in the three dimensional space. So Green's theorem we consider in the two dimensional space, whereas Stokes' theorem we consider in the three dimensional space. That is what the difference. So we say that Stokes' theorem is the generalization of Green's theorem. So coming to this problem, you are asked to evaluate the line integral f dot dr where f is given as 2zi plus 3xj plus 5yk. So we will apply this formula where even though this is the actual formula of Stokes' theorem, we are using this representation on the right hand side in order to evaluate the double integral over the surface S or sigma. Okay, that is integral over C f dot dr is equal to double integral over the region A curl or R curl f dot del g da. Now we find out the values on the right hand side. So we will first find out curl f. And what is curl f? As we already know, curl f is the determinant of I, j, k, dou by dou x, dou by dou y, dou by dou z, and f the components are 2z, 3x and 5y. Expanding it along the first row, I into dou by dou y of 5y is 5 minus dou by dou z of 3x is 0. Then minus j into dou by dou j into dou by dou x of 5y is 0 minus dou by dou z of 2z is 2. Then plus k into again dou by dou x of 3x is 3 minus dou by dou y of 2z is 0. So we get curl f is equal to 5i plus 2j plus 3k. So that is what curl f is. Now what we want to find out is what is del g. In order to know what is del g, we should know what is g. So I am recommending you to go through the first video or of Stokes' theorem, or the PDF I have given to you, the material I have given to you representing how we take del g in problems of Stokes' theorem. That means here we have given the surface as a paraboloid. So what is the paraboloid given by? It is the three-dimensional solid corresponding to a parabola. Parabola is a shape. It is a three-dimensional solid paraboloid. So the paraboloid is given by x square plus y square plus z is equal to 4. Which we can take as z is equal to 4 minus x square minus y square. And the representation is taken as z is equal to some function of x and y, isn't it? When you take, you can take any variable in terms of the other, but here we take like z is equal to 4 minus x square minus y square, so that z is equal to g of x y 4. And we have already given that we consider the surface g as z minus g of x y if the orientation is positive or counterclockwise. If the given curve which bounds the paraboloid is in the positive orientation, we take the surface equation of the surface G in the form z minus g of x y. Ennu parnal nammal ivide idengeyana g edukkendathu positive z direction ilana g edukkendathu karena positively oriented alle counter clockwise ennu parayumbol nammal ivide g edukkendathu z minus g of x y ennaanu. Is g of x y is the right hand side of this, that is z minus 4 minus x square minus y square. So that capital G is equal to z minus 4 plus x square plus y square. Okay, I think you understood how we take the capital G or equation and equation of the, or we call it as level surface. The equation of the surface is given as z minus of g of x y for positive z. You can see that the coefficient of z is positive here. So counterclockwise you will take the positive z direction such that z is in a positive sign. And so we take g is equal to z minus of g of x y is 4 minus x square minus y square. So already we have taken that g like that. Then we can find out del g. So then what is del g? By the formula for gradient, del g is I dou g by dou x plus j dou g by dou y plus k dou g by dou z. So I into what is dou g by dou x? G is z minus 4 plus x square plus y square. So with respect to x, the derivative is 2x, I into 2x plus j into dou g by dou y. What is the derivative of this with respect to y? 2y plus k into dou g by dou z. And what is the derivative of this? Into 1. Derivative of z with respect to z is equal to 1. So we will get this as del g is 2x I plus 2y j plus k. So we have got the terms required in the right hand side, that is curl of which is 5y plus 2j plus 3k and del g as 2xi plus 2yj plus k. Okay, now let us substitute that in the, I think it's better I will rub this also so that we can have. Now the formula is line integral over c f dot dr is equal to double integral over the area curl f dot del g da. Now we will substitute, which is equal to double integral over the area curl f is 5y plus 2j plus 3k dot then 2xi plus 2yj plus k da. Okay, now it is equal to, now we will take the dot product on the right side, double integral over a 5y dot 2xi is 10x plus 2j dot 2y is 4y plus 3k dot k is 3 into dA. Now what is dA? That is double integral over the area 10x plus 4y plus 3 into dA can be either dx dy or it can be dy dx, whatever we take, how we consider the region R. Now, okay, now we will consider what is the region given in the xy plane. As we have converted this line integral to double integral over a region A or region R, we should decide what will be the range of x and y, or what will be the image of the given paraboloid or given surface in the xy plane. As we have the paraboloid is x square plus y square plus z is equal to 2, z is equal to 4, we know that when z is equal to 0, that is the image in the xy plane. So that it becomes x square plus y square is equal to 4 is the image in the xy plane, or that is a circle. So in the xy plane, we will get a circle x square plus y square is equal to 4. Or as you already know, it is r square is equal to 4, r is equal to 2. We have discussed this in different problems. And again, I am asking you to take that in polar coordinates, that is x is equal to r cos theta, y is equal to r sin theta, and dx dy is equal to r dr d theta. And you will be doubting again why we are taking, instead of Cartesian, why we are taking polar. When we consider the Cartesian coordinate, the limit will be from minus root of 4 minus y square to plus root of 4 minus y square. And those who prefer to do in Cartesian coordinate, you can do like that. But I will recommend you to do in the polar coordinate, which will be more easier to perform the integral. So we have x equal to r cos theta, y is equal to r sin theta. And what is the range of r here? As we know that r ranges from drawing a line here, r ranging from 0 to the circle is equal to 2. And theta ranges from, being the full circle, we have theta ranges from 0 to 2 pi. So now we will consider the integral, double integral over the region. Then 10 into x. Now you have to replace x by r cos theta plus 4 into y, that 4 into r sin theta plus 3 into, we will write r dr d theta, where the range of r is 0 to 2, range of theta is 0 to 2 pi. That is equal to integral 0 to 2 pi, integral 0 to 2, 10 r square cos theta plus 4 r square sin theta plus 3 r dr then d theta. First of all, we will do the inner integral with respect to r, like integral 0 to 2 pi, then 10 into r cube by 3 cos theta plus 4 into r cube by 3 sin theta being constant plus 3 into r square by 2 within the limit 0 to 2 then d theta. So that now we have the value of the integral is equal to integral 0 to 2 pi 10 cos 10 by 3 cos theta, applying the upper limit, lower limit being 0, all the term in the lower limit will be 0. So upper limit applying r is equal to 2, so you get 2 cubed, that is into 8, 2 into 2 into 2, so that you will get 8 plus 4 by 3 sin theta into, again you have 2 cube, which is again 8 plus 3 by 2 into r square, which is equal to 4, then d theta. Now again we will integrate it with respect to theta, so that 10 by 3 into 8 is 80 by 3 into the integral of cos theta is sin theta plus 8 into 4 is 32 by 3 into integral of sin theta is minus cos theta plus 3 by 2, 1, 2 cancels. It becomes 2 into 3 into 2, that is 6 into theta within the limit 0 to 2 pi. Now applying the limits, what we get is 80 by 3, and what is sin 2 pi, upper limit sin 2 pi is 0, lower limit sin 0 is 0, plus minus 32 by 3, what is cos 2 pi, that is 1, what is cos 0, that is again 1, plus 6 into upper limit theta, that is 2 pi, lower limit is 0, so that you will get 80 by 3 into 0 plus this again 0 plus 12 pi. So our answer is 12 pi. So this is how we do the problem of a Stokes theorem, where first you have to identify curl f, then you have to identify del g, where g is obtained by taking either z minus g of x y if the curve is in the positively oriented or counter clockwise, or g of x y minus z in the case in which curve is negatively oriented. We will do one problem on that type of figure also, and that is how we evaluate, then apply that to the right hand side of the Stokes theorem and simplify it. And also do remember, whenever you have a integral in which in Cartesian coordinate which is feels to be very difficult to do, you can consider that if it is in a circle, you can consider that in a polar coordinate. Okay, thank you.